since the death of my mother, mixtape. Joella Murphy. I miss you, mama. It's a crazy woman. I miss you, mama. Miss Joella Murphy.
Y'all get on in here. Now listen, this is what I want to say. Now, all these niggas is rapping about. Now, I love Mo 3 to death. I'm one of the biggest, and I've never really listened to his music. Now, I love Mo 3 to death because he shot his way out of Fort Worth. He had some niggas with him, and these niggas in Fort Worth tried to put him in a fucked up situation, and they cost somebody else their life. So everybody tried to blame. Hey, what's going on, Miss Evan? Everybody try to blame Mo 3 for Half Heck's death in Fort Worth. Well, Half Heck shouldn't have been shooting in the air. Nigga, you don't pull no motherfucking gun out and shoot in the air, and y'all done trapped these niggas in a motherfucking cage. So that's how Half Heck got killed. So it wasn't Mo 3 fault that Half Heck got killed. But these old sour-hearted ass Fort Worth niggas that try to make it seem like it was Half Heck. Mo 3 fault that Half Heck got killed. That's not true at all. Half Heck got himself killed, y'all. Playing gangster. He come outside playing, shooting in the air rather than trying to find somebody to shoot at. But we was always taught, man, you don't pull that gun and shoot that gun. And they got him killed. So everybody in Fort Worth try to blame Mo 3 and celebrate Mo 3 death. All this goddamn rap music that we listen to. Same with Nipsey Hussle. Same with Pop Smoke. Same with King Von. King Von known for killing niggas. Wait, what's going on with it, Florida boy? King Von known for killing niggas. He on the Breakfast Club bragging about, B, I got two murders, one murder, two bodies. All these niggas brag about Nipsey Hussle. I keep killers with me, murders with me. So these niggas talk all this shit in these rap lyrics. These niggas do all this goddamn talking and rapping about how they shoot guns, and these niggas can describe the gun. And soon as it's time for some gangster shit for a rapper to have a gun, all the rappers getting killed without guns. Tupac, Biggie, they do all this goddamn talking about, got a gun, killed it, I'm a killer, I keep my gun on me, I sleep with my gun, I fuck with my gun, I tote my gun, I kiss my gun, everything with a goddamn gun. And that now, when these niggas getting in a situation, they dying with no gun. So I'm inclined to believe that we should be paying these. We just got to quit. See, these rapping niggas is some lying motherfuckers. Hey, some, how in the fuck did these niggas make all these goddamn videos? They make all the video with the goddamn gun. They make all the video with the goddamn gun, and it be 1,000 guns back there. 1,000 guns, nigga. Thought they'd be 1,000. And then, when it's time to have a gun, they ain't got no gun. They losing their motherfucking life. Because they playing. I keep telling y'all, the children are mimicking the rappers. The rappers are mimicking the street niggas. So everybody playing street. Man, I'm going to say this again. If you're in your house at nighttime, your wife sleep, your children sleep, and you sleep, and somebody, boom, kick in your door, and you raise up out your sleep, and you gotta get out of bed to go get your gun, you don't need a gun in the house. If you gotta go up in the closet, if you gotta open the closet and get the keys and unlock your this gun, man, you don't need no gun, bro. You playing. You playing. If you a rapper and you got a felony conviction and you're not supposed to be toting a gun, but you in your own city, you got rap problems, you got rap beef, or you got issues. There's nothing wrong with you risking going to jail so you can carry a gun and protect yourself. I bet Mo3 would much rather be waking up in loose scary jail than waking up wherever you go when you die. I bet he would much rather be waking up fighting, coming out of jail, fighting a pistol case than fighting Judgment Day. So soon. So I wonder, all these rapping niggas, when they get shot, when they get killed, when they get robbed, where them guns be that they be rapping so much about in they song? Man, I can't imagine going nowhere without this motherfucker. I remember being a little bitty band, and I first got a little 22. Then I got me a 25. And I remember holding that little bitty gun, saying, I'll never run from nobody. This thing right here will make sure that I never have to run from nobody. So I made sure I kept me a gun so I never had to run. Trip than flavor water. I ain't running from nobody with a gun. I got more trip than a painted car. Unless they gun bigger than mine. They bullets, bro. I got more trip than you could borrow. They bullets come out a little faster. I got more trip than a soda water. But I know as long as I got a gun, I got action. I got more drip than flavor water. Being able to protect myself. I got more drip than a painted car. I got more drip than you could borrow. So, it's just a thought. I got more drip than a soda water. I got more drip than a flavor car. If one more rapper die, Nipsey Hussle talk all that shit. Six old crib cubs. Yeah, man, they talk all that. Like but you listen to their motherfucker lyrics. You think these niggas got guns like tattooed on their hands? Pop Smoke. King Von. King Von got some motherfucking lyrics talking about, nigga, I'm gonna kill her this, I'm gonna kill her that. Then boom, you get killed with no gun. So somebody lying, y'all. The street niggas really lying. Portraying who they portraying. So the rap niggas mimicking the lying ass street nigga with the false street bullshit and the fake street codes and ethics and principles that don't nobody live by. And the rappers is lying. The rappers is lying. Shout out to the Ken Jones and shit. I stay fucking with Mississippi, baby. Yeah, I like fucking with Mississippi. Yeah, I swear. Good spirited people coming up out them bars. So, this is what I'm gonna have to say, and this is what I wanna say, and this will be my last time speaking on Mo3. I done gave myself 3 days. Process it, think about it, articulate it, and it's over with, right? Number one, and I hope his family hear me. I hope Rainwater hear me. I hope Trap Boy Freddy hear me. I hope Yellow Bees hear me. I hope Dallas hear me. I hope all the Mo3 fans and Mo3 haters hear me. Number one, Mo3 worked hard to get to where he was the other day. What do you mean by that? Say, man, that nigga works hard to get killed. It ain't funny, but it sounds funny. Mo3 worked very hard, my nigga, to die and to go out the way he went out. My nigga was gangster. He talked gangster. He rapped gangster. Nigga, all the gangster movies. Nigga, ain't that's how they die? So salute to that gangster, nigga. He went out how G supposed to went out, nigga. He lived it. He rapped it, he sung it, he stood on it, and them niggas brought it to him. So don't cry. My nigga worked hard. Go out like that. Number two, Trap Boy Freddy and whoever, or them other niggas, his haters, they thought by killing him, it was gonna stop his shine. That nigga shining brighter in death than he was alive. See how bright that nigga shining now? They thought by killing him, it was gonna stop his shine, it was gonna knock him off, and they was gonna be able to get the last laugh. But they couldn't predict, nor could they anticipate, nor could their minds even conceive or perceive the love and the level of compassion that he would get from the community, not just in Dallas, from all around the country. This brother done got love. They made him shine brighter. They thought it was gonna stop his shine. So not only did they elevate this nigga, they solidified his legacy as one of the greatest motherfucking rapping entertainers to ever come out of Dallas, Texas. They solidified that with their hate and their actions of murder. They elevated that man. And God gave him enough time to run, nigga, to get it right. I've been listening to his song, so I know he know God. I've been listening to that nigga's song. And to come from where he came from, the very bottom of our social economic status in life. The nigga come from sleeping in cars, sleeping on the bus, sleeping in apartments, working nigga dope trap, not knowing how to sell dope, realize the nigga say, fuck selling crack, I'm the crack. And the little nigga elevated himself from out of some of the worst conditions out of mankind. And look at him now. The nigga, they lit up the sky for him last night. It was beautiful to watch and see. It was beautiful to watch and see. Boy, they lit up the sky for him last night. And then to see a man such as great as Torrance Hatch, aka Lil Boosie, to come out and represent for his friend, represent for his protege, represent for his mentee, represent for his Boosie badass label affiliate. Man, that was beautiful to see. And to see that ball lit up in red, as them red balloons went up into a cloudy Dallas skyline. In the background, you got all them Dallas skyscrapers in the background. Some of the most remarkable building structures. Some of Dallas' most remarkable monuments is captured in the background of Mo3 fans, Mo3 pictures, Mo3 balloons going up in the sky. It was a beautiful sight to see. And I know the niggas who killed them, I know they felt some kind of way last night. See that love. They didn't think that love. See, they being hunted right now. See, he was causing pressure to niggas from what I heard while he was alive. So they had to kill the nigga because he was putting so much pressure on niggas. And so even now while he's dead, man, he's still hunting them niggas. Man, he got to be. So that's why them niggas got to put on the way they got to put on, because they hunted by their actions. Man, they didn't anticipate, man, the heavens to open up for this boy. God made man out of dirt, right? God made man out of dirt. He took this motherfucking ground and took that dirt and formed man and breathed life into that dirt and made it a human. Human, dark man. So it's my sincere and my honest belief that God loves playing in the dirt. He loves taking dirty motherfuckers. He loves taking dirty motherfuckers like Lil Melvin, Mo3, taking them out of far north Dallas, Fire Hill, little old dirty motherfucker, and playing in the dirt and formed him and elevated him. It's just that, as we all do, As we're elevating, we start to break ties from God. We start cutting off the stream that's lifting us. We start telling God, we got it. I got me here. And so pride gets in the way. Pride comes before destruction. We saw pride. Pride comes before destruction. So what do we see now? We see a prideful trap boy friend. Yellow Beezy kind of seems a little humble now. He really ain't with that, but you see a prideful trap boy Freddy. He's celebrating, popping bottles. I need 20 strippers. This is a Oak Cliff holiday, the pride of all these people. So what they have done now, they have brought a destructive curse over the community called Oak Cliff. It's just like when Jesus was being crucified and killed, and Pontius Pilate says, man, I ain't killing this motherfucker, nigga, he ain't done, I don't want his blood on my hands. And all the people in the crowd were saying, kill Jesus, fuck him, kill him, let his blood be on our hands, let his blood be on our children's hands and on our children's hands, kill him, fuck Jesus. And then they killed Jesus. And now everybody loves, man, well, we were wrong for killing Jesus. So as they celebrated the death of Jesus, and they said, oh, kill the motherfucker. And Jesus was a prophet of God. And as the story goes, it wasn't no white people in the crowd saying, kill Jesus, fuck Jesus, and let his blood be on our hands, and on our children's hands, and on our children's children's hands. So who were they talking about? Us? They cursed us. Celebrating Jesus, damn, fuck Jesus, damn. So Trap Boy Freddy and all the affiliates in Oak Cliff have brought about a curse on themselves by saying, damn, fuck him, fuck him.
Start to rise up like yeast. I just turned to a beast. After this interview with Young Cotton, I'm going to have to order some Uber Eats.
God got the last word last night. Did y'all see it? A rapist couldn't do that. Botham John didn't do that. Botham John didn't bring the streets out. The Bible says, Mama said, the Bible says that Jesus and Satan, well, how you love Jesus? Man, it's what you do for the least of those. The people out in the streets, the killers, the drug dealers, the whores, the prostitutes. That's who God really go bypass to go come get when he come back to earth. Who came out there last night? All those dry bones. All those dry bones. Ezekiel was commanded to go speak to dry bones. Last night, Lil Boosie, Rainwater, they was commanded by God through the death of Mo 3, Young Melvin, to go speak to all those dry bones. The preacher who will preach his funeral, who will give his eulogy, have been called by God to speak to those dry bones. All those young people who are possessed by rap music. They ain't listening to the people they possess by. They're not just listening and dancing to it. They're possessed by it. You don't see men and women dancing no more. You don't see men and women dancing no more. The music, it's a possession now. They're possessed by it. Blood in, blood out. Yeah, we were getting it through the drought. This word of mouth. Like man, this shit goes deeper. Came out to shoot the house. Now what they talking about? Then a trap boy Freddy Mo 3 Yellow Beezy. But ain't no love war from Young G's, put it down. This is a demonic force. Deal on how to make a million. BET Black Entertainment, baby. This is a demonic force. And that force just so happened to get one of God's souls. I came up with an idea on how to make a million. You can hear it in his music. BET Black Entertainment, baby, in the building. It's really no hiding the big facts. Fame comes pride, right? So when you cross over that threshold into that realm, when you go into celebrity status, when you go to being famous, when you go to being known, own. You step into a different entity. You enter into a different spiritual realm. The motherfuckers on the bottom, you can't get this. So when I tell y'all, when I went in there and I looked around and I peeked around, I said, whoa, man, I don't want this.
They stripping when we land. Tokyo, Germany, Canada, Japan.
Most of God's men, God's soldiers, God's children, when they enter into that entity, when they enter into that realm, the forces of those demons that comes with being a celebrity, the forces of those demons that comes with walking into that entertainment industry, man, why you think Dave Chappelle ran away from $60 million in the bank? Why you think them motherfuckers go crazy and said, I want to be broke free, I want out? Why? Niggas like Mo3 and Trap Boy Freddy, they don't even enter the heights of it. With the Werner Denzels and the T.I.s and it, they enter the little bottom part of it, the NBA. And look how powerful those dark forces are within. Imagine the higher you go when you go to get Oscars. Imagine. And all of our children want to enter into this kingdom. This is the kingdom everybody want to enter into, and this is what I'm telling y'all. To enter into this kingdom is to enter into the kingdom of Satan. You can't be in God's kingdom and enter into this land and remain there. You got to get in, and whatever you can get, you got to get out of there like stealing. You got to steal from the enemy's kingdom. You just can't think you should go in there and hang out, and they gonna let you walk out of there with the thing that the enemy give you to get into here. Damn it, I wish I could have talked to Mo3 before he died. God rest his soul. I won't speak on him no more.